Well, we are celebrating the start of Yahoo on the Road in style with having you headline here tonight, man.
Yes.
So we're looking forward to a beautiful theater, by the
way.
You never played here, right?
It's United Palace Theater. It's up in Washington Heights, which if you don't live in New York, you don't realize it's pretty far from the main body of Manhattan, but it's way up north. I never played here before. It's a beautiful place, and we're going to have a special night here tonight.
Well, it's exciting because you're going to be playing some songs from the new album, some songs you haven't played before.
Yes.
If you can describe the sound of the new record, what is it that maybe you're most proud of with this
one? Oh, it's soulful, it's sexy, it's modern, it feels, I don't know, it feels really good. I feel like, I worked with Kanye a lot on it, and we were just trying to make a really beautiful modern soul album, and I think we've managed to do that.
One of the songs you were playing during soundcheck, you had a great line that I'm sure I'm going to mess up, but you said something to the effect of, take you to my elevator and cook you breakfast later.
Yes.
What are you cooking for breakfast?
Well, that's from a song called The Beginning, which is on the new album. It's a breakfast. I'm actually quite good at cooking breakfast. That's one of my specialties. I'm very good at a breakfast sandwich. Uh-huh. So Chrissy's always got cravings for like sausage egg McMuffin. And I basically can make my own version of that homemade. We actually, for one of our friends recently, did a chicken and waffles Easter brunch.
Nice.
So I'm very good at fried chicken, and I'm decent at waffles. You just got to.
Chef legend.
You just got to put the iron
stuff
down.
Stuff in there. Always deliver in your live shows, and that's something you've really made a name for yourself on, obviously. What are some of your secrets for surviving life on the road? We're about to go on the road for a month.
Oh, well, if you don't have to sing, you have a little bit more leeway to have fun. Because when you have to sing, like, you have to preserve your voice. You have to talk, so
I'll be
as I have to sing, but
just as professional and taking care of myself.
So I don't
on the
drink
road,
when I'm on tour. I don't. I try to get a lot of rest. I work out. I just try to stay healthy because my body is my instrument, and I don't have the luxury to just let it get beat up too much.
Your thoughts on political issues?
Yeah.
Every time we get together, we always talk a little bit about what's happening in the news right now.
Yeah.
I know you're passionate guy. Is there one issue maybe that holds a special place in your heart right now?
I'm focused on education. My charity, we spend a lot of time on education, and we see it with these budget cuts, the sequester and all these things where they're cutting Head Start, they're cutting all these other resources that could, you know, go toward investing in the future. It's terrible to me because it's really neglecting what we need to do for the future of the country, to be strong, to be productive, to be, to let kids have the opportunity to live the American dream.
Do some movies, you have a new album, you're on tour, you're making waffles.
Yes.
You're politically involved. You're really like setting the bar high for all of us to keep up.
I'm
you know
just having
that, right?
Fun. Like I just get to do what I love to do every day. I get to make music. I get to put out art and try to put out more beauty in the world. That's like the best job in the world.
Did you ever get nervous before a show like tonight? We were a few hours away from you going on the stage. You've done it so many times
really.
Now.
Not really. I don't really get too nervous, but this was different because I have a string chamber orchestra behind me. It's a little more, it needs to be a little tighter than normal, because if I was just sitting up there by myself, or even if I was with my band, there's a little more room for improvisation. But when you're up there with a chamber orchestra, they're literally reading every single note, and that means I have to stay disciplined and I can't like repeat something an extra time.
Mm-hmm.
I can't like kind of be as free as I want. So it's a little more focus required.
Well, I was going to ask you, when you decide to go into the studio to make a record, what is it that is driving you to do that? Is it the same thing every time? You sort of feel an itch to get out there and create a new body of work?
Oh, I love writing. I love the creative process. I love the kind of challenge of, you know, trying to make something beautiful. And it's so fun to do it. I love collaborating with other people to do it. I love doing it myself. It's just awesome when you can go in one day and have nothing and leave that day with a new song. It's like one of the coolest feelings you could feel. And when it's really good, then it's even better.
Well, congratulations, man, on the new record.
Thank
and thanks
you.
For setting off this Yahoo on the Road series
Thank
in style.
You.
You're raising the bar for everybody else who's following you, man. It's good to see you.
Thank
as
you very
always.
Much. Thank you.